Hello everybody, welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in 7 Days to Die. It's been a while, and so you're gonna have to all bear with me. And yeah, today is day 20. Oh, math, how much I hate you. So I think we have 7, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. That's what I thought. So the next day coming up will be the day 21 hard, which means that we need to do some collection of resources. I put a bunch of concrete in places, but we still have cobblestone. So I think the goal will be to drive around to some of those rocks and, yeah, and just collect some stuff. It's going to be nothing exciting. I want to try and build this whole thing here, but, oh man, one day we'll do that. We'll do it properly. We'll put the drawbridge back in. I need the resources for that, of course. Let's throw this hammer there. We have plenty of food and everything. We don't need anything special there. I am wearing a mining helmet, which we can probably wear for the other thing when we start heating up. So we'll turn that off. So they fixed the mining helmet, I think, in this version, which is nice. So yeah, so what are we going to talk about today? Well, I'm going to try and do this video with the least amount of editing that I can do, and we'll go from there. So I'm going to drive towards the town. I'm actually going to drive this way because I want to dig up the rest of that road. If you remember, in one of my videos, I was digging up some of these gravel roads because they have stone and sand, and that's just what I need. I think we're going to need a little bit of clay as well, maybe. So I wanted to kind of check out that army base there one time. But man, just, I don't know. It's either resource collection, work on the base, or go looting, do stuff like that. And it's day 20, so I think we're going to do nothing exciting. But I'll probably just talk about stuff this episode. So yeah, so thank you for watching. I appreciate it. I appreciate all those people who subscribe to me. That's awesome. Thank you for that as well. I appreciate you for doing that. I appreciate you for hitting that subscribe button, because I'm no pro YouTuber, just somebody playing video games, recording it, blah blah blah, right? Trying to do this as if, you know, as if I was making money from it. You know, this is just a fun little hobby. So I'm gonna go down over here. I'm gonna take my time, I'm gonna dig this up, and yeah, I'll be right back when that is over, of course. And I think, see these little rocks here? Maybe we'll take those rocks as well, potentially, but I'm gonna have to clear out these zombies. So yeah, here we go. Hey! Ah! I don't have armor in this one. I'm getting this mixed up with my multiplayer. So yeah, so I will see you all shortly. So, oh, perfect. So here we are. We are done. This is what I've collected, just a little bit, not much. These you can actually dig about 3 down, which is pretty amazing. Just a ton of gravel there. I'm kind of curious how deep it goes. So that's kind of like an experiment that we're doing over there. Let's kind of head down towards town here. So yeah, so I have some talking points that I kind of want to run through. It's kind of like a special for all of you people who are watching my videos, kind of like a thank you for being here type of thing. And yeah, so I'm going to kind of go after these rocks. And yeah, so let's kind of discuss this. So point number one, family. So as you all know, as you can, of course, tell, you know, whoever is actually watching this video and is watching this part of the video, thank you very much for your ears, thank you very much for your time. Oh, look how convenient, there's some clay, you need this clay. You thank you for your ears, your eyes, you whatever, thank you for, yeah, for clicking on this video. You know, I know there's a few of you that you continue to watch my channel, and thank you. So yeah, so back to my talking points. So family. So lately I've been just spending a lot of time with family. YouTube is just a hobby. It's just something for fun to do. It's a social activity. I'm gonna take a drink here of my water. Yeah, yum. Water's good. And yeah, and so we've been doing the cleanup around the house, and so that's where everything comes down to time. I have to work at a full-time job, unfortunately, and it kind of, it's a job. What do you expect, right? What more excitement is there in a job? Pays the bills, allows me to play video games when I get the chance, and today presents the opportunity. It's on a day where we do the multiplayer stuff, which is pretty cool. But yeah, but family, I'm thankful for family. I'm thankful that, they allow me to do this kind of stuff. Other people might think that's crazy. Oh, well, you should be able to do it whenever you want. Well, yeah, but you gotta do stuff for the family as well. You gotta spend time with your kids. You gotta make sure that, everyone's doing everything that they're supposed to be doing. It's just the way life is. It's the way the life of an adult is. And so, yeah. So I'm thankful for Lushable Echo. He is somebody that we play with every week. He's my brother, and yeah, it's pretty awesome that he is able to host a server, and which allows people to play on. We use a Discord to communicate with each other, and there's been a little group of us, which I appreciate every single one of these people, and I'm thankful that they come and play and everything and all that fun razzmatazz, right? There's no order to these names. There's no priority. It's just the way I listed them out in my head, and it's just the way they came out. So, yeah, so don't be offended if you're at the bottom, because it doesn't matter. You're all great people. And so, yeah. So, every week we usually all get together, and there's usually a bunch of us. There's Lushable, there's myself, there's Blaze Niner, there's Commander Keen, there's Evil Giraffe, there's Jace Machine, there's some guy, and there's Dugamus that comes by. And depending on who comes, determines what game we play, right? So like last time it was just Blaze or Niner, Commander Keen, and Lushable, and so we decided to play some Stellaris, and that was pretty fun. We enjoyed that quite thoroughly, and yeah, and so that was a good moment. It allowed us to play a little bit of a different game. Test out some live streaming. We do some live streaming. I'm gonna put relevant links and whatnot in the description down below, so definitely check that out because that is very, very, very important. Let's see here. I'm kind of just looking at my points here while I'm trying to dig, and that's very challenging for some of you. That might be all, that's easy, come on you noob, ha ha ha. So let's carry on here. So as I said, we communicate with each other through Discord. Now basically the process to play with us, it's pretty simple. Anyone can come play with us. You don't have to be a YouTuber. You can just be somebody that watches our channels, or so you could be like a subscriber. What am I doing? I'm lost here. Where's the road? Here it is. You can be a subscriber that watches us, or any of the other people who I've mentioned. And if you want to play with us, then basically for each iteration of Alpha 15, well, 15, every Alpha, basically, ever since Alpha 3, we've been doing a server for each iteration of the game, right? I mean, that's only just because, what am I doing here? I'm looking for rocks. Rocks are going to be in the outskirts. And so basically for each iteration of the game, we play this game, and we play, just kind of, I see a bunch of rocks there. We basically play a new server, right? We start all over, we change the rules up, we try a few different things here and there. And so the last kind of thing with Alpha 15 we tried was a multiplayer server with some PvP, and the PvP is fun, but it's just the nature of the game, the way it's designed, and because you have to build a base, Everyone tends to stick around their base and in the areas around the base. There's usually about a 3 or 4 kilometer radius. Well, radius, for me, it's about a radius, about a 4 or 5 kilometer radius where I stay around my base and do the relevant things. So whether it's harvesting, whether it's mining, it's even similar to this. Like, look at this game world, right? Like, we've only really stayed around here. I've never really gone anywhere outside of this town because this town is so huge that it's able to sustain us right into day 21, right? So yeah, so it's similar to the multiplayer, and it's awesome when we all get together and play, and we're all on Discord. We're all having a blast, and I think Alpha 16, the PvP stuff kind of worked, but I think it was just a challenge. It was a challenge to get people to fight each other. Like, I had somebody coming and attacking me. Dugmus, of all people, was attacking me, and that was hell fun, right? Hell fun. So I think what we'll do maybe for Alpha 16, or at least what I'm envisioning, is if we're going to return back to the non-PvP nature, I would say keep PvP turned on, but you'll do it where we all ally with each other and we can make the same base. And this way we can do kind of like the PvP achievements still outside of the horde days and stuff, right? So maybe we can stand at the base and just kill each other like 10, 100 times or whatever to get the achievement, I guess. Guess it doesn't matter. We could do it legit, and that's how I would like to do it, but we would need to force people within a closer environment, right? So, if we were to do PvP in the future, I would say basically you make yourself a day 7 base and just say people, these are safe havens. We could still use the land claim blocks to protect it, but I don't know. I would say you make a 7-day base, do it as like a safe haven, so people aren't allowed to raid them and whatnot. And then we find like a centralized city or town that we can all move into, and then boom, PvP time in that town. So that's how I would like to feel. Maybe unless, if people say, yeah, cool, you can attack my base anytime, then you can attack the base. But if people didn't want that, then maybe allow that choice. I'm not sure. It's kind of weird when you do PvP and you try to do it like kind of like Rust style. It works, but it doesn't. I don't know, it's really weird. It's really easy to do PvP with like an open server, so I think that's the other kind of challenge. But anyways, back to what I was talking about with my talking points. This is how it's gonna be. I'm just gonna go through my talking stuff, and once it's done, it's done. And the next time you'll see me will be at the Day 7 Horde. I'm just gonna do a bunch of the monotonous stuff here, and yeah. So I'm gonna continue with all of this. So, what else can we talk about? YouTube channel. So basically, the YouTube channel, the direction. So I'm gonna take another drink. Okay, so I had a particular idea, oh man, of how I wanted the YouTube channel to progress, right? So when I first started doing this, it was within the Minecraft days, and I was kind of learning and trying to get some growth and everything. And more recently here, I've seen a bunch of subscribers come on, and so if you're one of those few people that are watching me at this point, hey, great, thank you. I appreciate you for just for subscribing. That's awesome. It's awesome always to see people come and hop on for the first time and kind of watch the content. Hopefully it's good enough content. I don't promise anything with my content, but at the same time, I just try and have fun and have a good time, and I got all my forged steel with me. I wonder why. Oh well, I guess this is the single player, so I don't really care too much. On the multiplayer, I wouldn't even have this on me. I would have it hidden away behind blocks and everything, and I should go back out there because that's really what I want. I was just dismantling my car, got distracted. Yeah, this game distracts me in every way, this is why I like it. I can just sit there and do one thing and then all of a sudden start to do another thing, and yeah. So YouTube channel and direction. I'm gonna try and stay focused on this topic. So basically, your Minecraft days, blah blah blah. I was learning how to do videos, and if you go back and take a look, man, cringeworthy. That's also before I did editing. It's also before I kind of tried to chop up any large gaps and all that fun stuff. I'm more lazy now. I don't really try and do that, but then I try and fill in that space with gabbing or talking or mindless talking. Half the time, I kind of get into this kind of tunnel, and then I just kind of mindlessly talk, like what I'm doing at this point. But I'm just demonstrating, right? But basically, I just wanted the channel to grow. I wanted people to watch me, and at one point, it turned into, well, hey, can I make money with this? And then when you start looking into it, start looking into how to make money, and it's a big long road, and I commend people for doing that. The YouTubers that actually do make the money, good for them, but I think unfortunately their time is dominated by this, right? By recording. Recording's the fun part. That's the easiest part. The tough part I find for me. Maybe I could be completely wrong, and if that's the case, I'm just a noob and whatever. But so what I find is the editing process. I could be going through this all this footage because I have to rewatch it and make sure I'm giving you a quality product. And so basically, I would rewatch everything again as I'm editing. I would chop out pieces. I would kind of do all of that so that way it's a quality video. So sometimes I rewatch my video and it just takes a long time for me to get it out. So if people are able to do this quicker, if they have a better vision, maybe it's just the tools that I use, maybe my tools aren't as good. So for these ones, these new 7 Days to Die videos, I'm using basically Windows Movie Maker, which is just a freebie one, but they have a 64-bit version. And so I've been looking for a 64-bit video editor, and they're actually quite challenging to find unless you want to pay for the high-end ones, which unfortunately just I'm not doing this as a job. If I was making money through ad revenue and all that stuff, which I'm not even hooked up. I would have to create a whole new account. I would probably even have to create a whole new channel for that. Oh, where's the road? I would have to create a whole new channel for that. Man, this stuff sucks. Oh, there we go. I should just look for the house. I would basically have to create a whole new channel because I need to link it to a different email account. I can't use this one unless I can use a different AdSense email. I don't know. I would have to create a website. You kind of go legit. Now you're talking about more funds being dumped into the project. Is there anything in this car? So yeah, I don't know. It's really weird, I find. Once you start traveling down that road, down the road of, do we have any more rocks? You're down that road of trying to become like a YouTuber, right? And yeah, it's really interesting. It's really interesting. I've just done a lot of research, and I don't know if it's something I want to do. I just want to have a good time, play some video games, meet some cool people, maybe play with some people on a regular basis like I do, and maybe have a few people on the Discord kind of talk and having a good time, because that's where you'll find me, is basically on that Discord channel. I do have my own Discord channel. Again, I'm just going to reiterate, relevant links will be down below. So for all of you who are continuing to watch at this point, I commend you. I commend you, because I don't know, sometimes I just don't think my stuff is that good. I try, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just not made out for it. Maybe it's not for me. It's one of those things, right? I've been kind of rethinking everything and kind of rethinking the whole YouTube thing, and I've been taking a break from all of this just so I can kind of figure out in my headspace what's going on, and and you see how we can progress. And just today, there is some time. The wife doesn't have to go into work too soon. And so actually, we can use the map to look for rocks. If you just zoom in, so you can see right here, there's a patch of rocks which we can go and devour. And so yeah, so I'm gonna continue doing this, and I have a few more points to talk about. So let's do that while I chop up these rocks here, and we have another trash that we can loot. Exciting, exciting. I'm destroying those because I don't want to reloot them. I don't care if there's like a loot respawn that exists, because it doesn't matter to me. I have another car here that we can loot. I think I already looted it, so let's actually dismantle it. I'm kind of in this area here, this little a peninsula thingy. Man, so almost day 21 in this game. That's pretty cool. So I guess schedule. As you noticed, I used to be on a more regular schedule. I used to try and get a video out every week, but I don't know, just with Christmas and the holiday season, just nothing was conducive. So here I am now making a video. So yeah, so those of you who are still around, thank you. I'm gonna thank you all the way through this, because that's just I appreciate it, right? That's just kind of where I lie. Is, out of all the people you could be watching, right, you could be watching more bigger ones. I'm gonna grab another drink. So dry in the winter here, man. So dry. So that's why I drink water all the time. And it doesn't help. But basically, where I was going with all this is just, I wanted to be on a regular schedule. Maybe one day I will return to that. Maybe once, life circumstances change, maybe the little guy gets a little bit older, once he's not as high maintenance as he is now. He's amazing, the little guy, right? But unfortunately, he's just has a lot of stuff, right? It's just, you gotta keep him busy, you gotta play with him, you teach him stuff, you gotta take care of him, change his bum, or teach him how to go potty, and all that trial and error fun stuff, right? It's all part of life, and living and experiencing life on this planet here. So iron pickaxe, I think we'll craft another one of these bad boys. We will go back to our bike, which is probably over here somewhere, and drop off this stuff. So yeah, so anyways, one day I'll return to schedule. But you basically, with Alpha 16, I'm gonna kind of go into that now. So with Alpha 16, we're still gonna do the multiplayer server. I'm not sure what kind. Probably won't be the same kind of PvP if we do PvP again. I would like to do PvP again, because I would like to kind of, you get those achievements. But maybe we can do PvP outside of the 7 days, or I don't know. Maybe we can create a common base that we all go to on the 7 days, and that way then we're kind of together, kind of not. And maybe the people that want to PvP can PvP, kind of. I don't know. We'll have to figure something out, because I kind of want a PvP, but you may be in a controlled environment, so that way then there's more chances of it, I think. This is kind of what I would like to see. Be kind of, yeah, I think that's kind of what I'm leaning towards. I'll put that there. So let's see here. Food or thirst. Is that thirst? That is thirst, but we don't need any of that stuff. So did we not loot anything in here? So this is the problem. So I want to try and methodically go through this. I want to go through the block, and if the block is done, then we'll put kind of a marker down, I guess. I don't know. I don't know. This is the one thing I struggle with these games, is I don't know when I've completed a house or anything, because I just kind of haphazardly go and loot. Like, there's this car we're passing by, which I should stop and dismantle maybe. But I want to go down to the corner, and it's still kind of daytime, so I want to see if there's any more kind of shopping carts that we can dismantle. I wonder if there's any in here, because the shopping carts give you mechanical parts, and that's, kind of key for what we're doing here. So yeah, so back to Alpha 16. So basically with Alpha 16, what I am going to do personally is I am going to, of course, start a new map. I'm going to turn the settings on and all the way up. I'm going to crank it. We're going to make it, you know, basically hardcore, because that's what I feel like. I'm going to make the difficulty all the way up as well, so which means that it's going to be a lot more challenging than, ooh, stuff here. A lot more challenging than what you've seen it to be, because on the multiplayer server we've been playing with you pretty much cranked settings, and it actually hasn't been too bad. It's been really, really fun. There's been a lot of close calls, a lot of moments where I've almost died, but in general, I don't know, it's been pretty cool. So just kind of collecting some resources here. Did we check all these cars? I think we did. We should have, because I'm usually pretty good with looting places. I don't think I looted this place though, unless I went through the window. Yeah, that's probably where I went through. Let's just open this door. It's nice we can get through there faster. I hope there's no mines in here. Yeah, we already looted stuff. Of course we did. There's probably money in here. Let's just do a quick looting run. More stuff. Guess I can't scrap that. I can scrap that in the multiplayer. Just not here. So going to the cloth. This is going to be leather that we can chop. Right, leather and wood. That's it. There's like nothing in here. There might be. Is this the outside? Yeah, that's the outside. So this might be something. Is this the washroom? Yeah, okay. Let's give me the washroom. Some stuff in here. Suitcase. Might be good stuff in there. No. There could be some medicine stuff, which we don't have room for. Cupboards. Oh, another wrench. Sweet, sweet. So, we don't need the dukes. We need the tin can, we can scrap. We want the beans. Moldy bread. It's, we'll keep the casino tokens because we're trying to collect those. I shouldn't really be looting. I'm not really equipped to loot. This has an upstairs. That's cool. There's a thing on the other roof there. That is fine and dandy. Okay. So let's kind of carry on. See, this is what I mean. Like, I get distracted. And, yeah. So, Alpha 16. So, what was I talking about? I was talking about increasing the settings. Because we've been playing on higher settings. So, I'm definitely going to do that. Because I don't mind them being more challenging. Plastic, I don't know if I need that. But on the same note, they're just really easy right now. Now, it could be because I leveled up and all that fun stuff. So if this is the corner, this is where we kind of start looting from, right? Now, do we do selective looting? Or do we make sure we're empty? Are there stones nearby? I think there's stones over there. Let's take a quick peek. Yeah, there are stones over there. So maybe we can collect more stone. Let's see what we can put into our bike here. We can throw another wrench in there. We can throw the pine seed. Mechanical parts we can't throw in there. We can throw the leather in there. We can throw the cloth. Nice, nice. I don't think we can throw anything else. We can refuel, but that doesn't take much. Okay, so we can keep harvesting some stone there, because we need some resources to repair with, right? That's kind of the plan, so let's do that. Just take this pickaxe here, and I'm going to continue with this, and I'll be right back. Perfect, so this is our haul. So this is what I have on me. I'm going to head back now, because I'm done with that. It's stupid how the sound effects do that. It really bugs me. So I'm basically gonna head back. So, and then once I'm back, I'm just gonna organize all the stuff into the appropriate boxes. Then we're gonna turn on the forges and stuff, and I'm gonna start working on the rest of the wall. and basically trying to get that up to concrete before the horde. I'm gonna make some cobblestone stuff to prepare with because I'm not sure if I'll be able to get it all into concrete. So we'll have to definitely be on the lookout for that. And so I guess just some final points here, just to kind of reiterate, if you're still with me, if you're still watching, thank you. Definitely choose to press that subscribe button if you like the content, or if you just like my effort, go for it. And other than that, what else am I gonna say? Thank you. Thanks for your eyeballs. Thanks for your time. I appreciate your time because time is very valuable in my. Oh shit! Are you fucking serious? Okay, man, that's terrifying me. I thought I was going through the wall. Why was it rendering that way? That's brutal. Come on. Come on, come on, let's get out of here. Let's go. Whoa! Don't hit the tree. Don't hit the tree. What's going on here? The game's not running too well for me. Let's go through. Ah! Oh man, no! Everything's happening so fast. What's going on? The game's running like crap for me. Has it been that long that I've been into these areas that it has to re-render them? So weird. I don't know, man. I've been having glitches. Oh, here we go. I think it's just that fact. It's just the fact that I need to get back to my base. Cause, man, good thing I don't need to. It's been a while since I've played on this. That's why. That's another problem. I need to play this more often. But thank you. And at least you see me make it back here. I should put a thing on this side of the platform. Come on, come on. There we go. Perfect. I'm gonna hop this stuff into my base. So I guess I'll see you all in the next episode. And should I finish off with anything here? Yeah, just Alpha 16 if you want to join us. And then kind of look up the Lushable Echo on Twitch Steam group. Reach out to Lushable for the Discord server, and he'll give you an invite. And then once you've got that, then you're pretty much you're good to go to play with us. And then whenever we host our server, it will be through that process. As well, we usually typically play every Sunday until things change in the future, as of this recording, which is January 22nd. So definitely check us out. We're just a casual group to play with, have a good time, all that fun stuff. Nothing really special. And let's see about loading this stuff up. Come on, why didn't you go in there? And let's turn it on. And so that's about it. Thank you everybody for watching. Thank you for bearing through my rambling. And yeah, I'll see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.